I'm going to use the smallest die size in our tubing bender. This does from 3/16 up to 3/8. The smallest die will actually do the 3/16 and the quarter inch without kinking either size.
Now I see there's marks here on the side. Hey Joe, can you get in and get see if you can get this to see?
So what's nice about this tool is that it'll give you marks on the side to tell you what degree you're at. So that way you can do a repeatable bend. Say you wanted to do a 45, and then flip it over and do a 45 to kind of create an offset in the tubing. This will let you do that.
So you just bend it until this mark lines up with a 45 or with a 90 or whichever you want
exactly.
to go, right?
Exactly. You can do up to 180 degree bend with this tool.
All right, let's check it out.
So we got our tubing. So I'm just gonna do a little 45. And that way, it'll get us some height off from, say, this was the rear differential, and you wanted to drop down and follow the axle tube. And then now, we need to bend up to get to our wheel cylinder. So I'm gonna do that.
Uh-oh.
It is a little tricky to remember which way to go. So you want to be cognizant about what plane you're in when you're doing your bends. So now we're up to 90 degree bend. We're going to do one last bend. This will get us to what would be the wheel cylinder.